There's currently a lot of talk about what causes global warming. And global warming is something that's happened throughout Earth's history due to a multitude of causes that I talked about in many videos. But what about cooling? What causes ice ages? Global glaciations, or ice ages, are major periods during which continental ice sheets cover a significant portion of Earth's surface. We are currently in an ice age, and I talk about this in my Modern Ice Age video, which I will link up to the top right for you. However, how many ice ages have there been throughout Earth's history? How long did they last, and what caused them? Was it the same things as caused the current ice age, or was it different things, and why? So the top five ice ages throughout Earth's history, there's been many, some less intense than others, but the top five, based on my research, include the Huronian ice age, or the first Snowball Earth event around 2.4 to 2.1 billion years ago, which coincided with the Great Oxidation event. The Cryogenian, which included kind of two side-by-side events, the Sturtian and the Marinoan glaciations, which were kind of the second two Snowball Earth events, or one Snowball Earth event, depending on whether you combine these or separate these. And these spanned from around 720 to 635 million years ago, and they coincided with the Neoproterozoic oxygenation event, the second major oxidation event in Earth's history. And then the Andean Saharan, or the Ordovician ice age or cooling event that contributed to the and Ordovician mass extinctions, and I talk about this in my Ordovician mass extinction video. I'll link it to the top right if you're curious. But this occurred from around 450 to 420 million years ago. And then we have the Karoo, or the Carboniferous ice age, which was kind of a really long one that spanned from around 360 to 260 million years ago and was the largest ice age in the Phanerozoic eon, so since the Cambrian period. Then we have the modern ice age, or Quaternary ice age, from around 2.6 or 3-ish million years ago to present. And like I mentioned, there was a cooling trend that got kind of kicked off around 30 something million years ago, and then it worsened or intensified around 2.6 million years ago. And that is what we define as the current or Quaternary glaciation. Again, there have been other smaller or localized events, but these are the major ice age events through Earth's history. But what has caused these events? Or in general, what causes ice ages or cooling? The major causes of ice ages have tended to be solar radiation and/or Earth's orbit and changes in Earth's orbit, which affect the amount of solar radiation received by Earth. So things like changes in Earth's orbit or eccentricity or wobble or precession or tilt or obliquity. These are the layman's terms for these, and these are the sciencey terms for these. And so changes in these aspects of Earth's orbit around the sun have affected the distribution of solar radiation across Earth's surface and the intensity of the solar radiation received at Earth's surface. For example, when the angle of Earth's tilt or obliquity is smaller, the poles receive less solar radiation, and this drives ice cap growth. Also, the gravitational pull from other planets has caused Earth's orbit to vary from near circular to slightly elliptical. And when it's more circular, the amount of sunlight received remains more constant throughout the orbit, whereas when it's more elliptical, the amount of sunlight varies drastically and it's more intense at the parts where it's closer to the sun. And this can change the length of seasons on Earth. But there are other causes of cooling. These include decreasing greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, like CO2 and methane, which we know trap warmth on Earth, volcanic eruptions associated with ash and sulfur dioxide release, which can block sunlight. Yes, volcanic eruptions can also cause warming, typically in the longer term, but there is a cooling effect of volcanic eruptions that release ash and sulfur aerosols that block sunlight. And this can happen kind of typically in the shorter term and then drives warming long term because the sulfur and the ash typically rain out or drop to the surface of Earth and deposit, whereas carbon compounds like carbon dioxide that are released by volcanoes stay in the atmosphere over geologic timescales and drive warming over the long term. Also, plate tectonics can cause cooling by altering ocean and atmospheric circulation. The modern ice age is one example of this when Antarctica became isolated and changed ocean circulation to the point that waters there were isolated and continued to cool rather than mix with warmer waters. This drove ice cap growth at the South Pole. And so this was the Eocene-Oligocene, or 34 million year ago, trigger of the initial cooling trend that eventually led us into the modern ice age today. And solar output is another major factor that can cause cooling. I talked on the previous slide about solar radiation changes due to changes in Earth's orbit. However, solar output itself has changed over time, meaning the sun's intensity has actually increased through Earth's history ever since the solar system formed. But the relative influence of each of these causes has changed over time and changes for each ice age event. Snowball Earth events, for example, were largely caused by life and tectonics. Life because cyanobacterial mats that took up a bunch of CO2 to photosynthesize caused cooling by decreasing CO2 in the atmosphere around 2.4 billion years ago, leading to the first Snowball Earth event. And then the breakup of Rodinia and potentially early greening of land and more photosynthesis led to the second Snowball Earth event or events around 700 million years ago. Both of these, however, both these life and tectonic triggers actually lead to the same cause of the cooling. This would be a decrease in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The reason being is cyanobacteria took up carbon dioxide directly from the atmosphere, and the greening of land surfaces around 700 million years ago would have done the same thing. But also the breakup of Rodinia, the breakup of this supercontinent around 700 million years ago, would have increased continental weathering rates, which increase carbon burial in the rock record, which stores carbon. It takes up carbon from the atmosphere and oceans and stores carbon long-term in the rocks, causing a long-term cooling event. And so both weathering and life led to, eventually, the decrease in atmospheric carbon. And that is what directly caused these cooling events. But causes of more recent ice ages include other factors. The major causes of the Andean Saharan or the Ordovician ice age event around 450 million years ago include the shifting or kind of emplacement of Gondwana over the South Pole. Gondwana was a large landmass at the time that shifted over the South Pole at the time, which drove cooling of that landmass and therefore continental glaciation, which intensified cooling more so because the more glaciation you have, the more reflective that continental surface becomes and the more solar radiation that's reflected and thus the more cooling that occurs. And so that drove cooling. Also, there were basaltic eruptions that occurred during this time, and that is a relatively weatherable rock. And again, the more continental weathering you have, the more cooling you have because it drives carbon burial. Also, other continental land masses shifted to be basically directly under the intertropical convergence zone, or basically where a lot of rainfall occurs. And this rainfall would have further driven weathering and carbon burial. We also had the tectonic orogeny occurring at the time, a mountain building event that would have also increased weathering, and the spread of non-vascular plants over land. I talk about all of these factors and how exactly they came to be and what they caused in my Ordovician mass extinction event video, but the gist is all of these four factors would have caused enhanced weathering and carbon burial, and the movement of Gondwana over the South Pole would have just increased glaciation and sea level fall. And sea level fall is another thing that would have enhanced continental weathering and carbon burial. And the more carbon burial you have, the less carbon in the atmosphere you have. And this caused more cooling and more glaciation. So again, even though this Ordovician event had different specific causes or triggers than the Snowball Earth events in the Precambrian, overall, it was really the same cause or ultimate direct cause, which was less carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The major cause of the Karoo or the 360 million year ago Carboniferous ice age was intense carbon burial in coal swamps. We all associate the Carboniferous period as being this really swampy world, and it really was, at least for its first half. And then in the middle of it, after all of this swampiness caused super abundant amounts of carbon burial within these swampy regions, that triggered an ice age. And for the second half of the Carboniferous, it became cooler and drier. And this drying and cooling trend continued until the mid-Permian, until warming kicked in again, and we had this major warming event and carbon release event during the end Permian, and that is what led to the end Permian mass extinction, or the Great Dying, or the greatest extinction event of all time. But just before it, there was this ice age. And again, we noticed the same theme with this one. Even though coal swamps is a different initial trigger than the previous Snowball Earth events and Ordovician ice age, the overall effect that directly caused the ice age, or the cooling event, is still the same. It's still carbon burial and a decrease in atmospheric carbon. The Quaternary, or the current ice age that started around 2.6 million years ago, was initially triggered by tectonics. Again, the isolation of Antarctica was one thing that occurred 34 million years ago that kind of helped along the cooling later on. But more close to the beginning of this ice age was the connection of North and South America around 3 million years ago that shifted ocean circulation to the point that it led to the cooling of both North Polar waters, and at that point we had the cooling of South Polar waters because of the isolation of Antarctica, and so these two poles were cooling and glaciation spread. I talk more about how this connection affected ocean circulation and caused cooling in my Modern Ice Age video that I linked earlier. But it's important to note that since these initial tectonic triggers of the modern ice age, the interglacial cycles, so the expansion during glacial maxima of the current ice age and the retreat during glacial minima, those have been driven by Milankovitch cycles, which are cycles in Earth's orbit or excentricity, tilt or obliquity, and wobble or precession. The overall cooling over time, or the overall average temperatures over the last 3 million years, was triggered by tectonics. However, these up and down periods that has caused glacial maxima and minima have been driven by these astronomical factors. The shift from earthbound factors to astronomical factors is not necessarily real, meaning that the ancient events or ancient ice ages may have actually been in part caused by such astronomical factors like the modern ice ages. But although we can observe the relationship between astronomical changes or changes in Earth's orbit with the modern ice age because we're here, we can't necessarily do so for past events. At least to my knowledge, I think it's much harder to reconstruct past astronomical or Earth orbit changes compared to reconstructing climatic and environmental changes. This is my understanding. I don't study this. I study rocks and how to reconstruct climatic changes, so I don't know if there's a way to reconstruct astronomical changes. If somebody knows, please comment down below. I'm ignorant to this. But it seems to me it would be really difficult. Therefore, they likely played a role in these past events. We just can't say relatively how large a role they played compared to other factors like tectonics, volcanism, solar output, and atmospheric gases, which are things that we can reconstruct using the rocks in Earth's record. So overall, it seems the answer to what causes ice ages has tended to be a decrease in atmospheric carbon, in addition to, you know, major tectonic changes that drive ocean circulation changes. And then once cooling is triggered, it seems that astronomical factors like changes in Earth's orbit tend to cause interglacial cycles, and that may have occurred throughout Earth's history in all of the ice ages, but it's harder for us to really see that detailed of information within the rock record. In any case, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to check out my references, they're linked in my description box below. And if you want to check out other videos where I talk about ice ages on my channel, you could check out the modern ice age video here, and you can check out my Snowball Earth video here, where I talk about all the Snowball Earth events. Thank you guys again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!